What is going on, guys? Mr.FaNaTiC here, back with another Call of Duty Ghost commentary. Not live, thankfully. But I'm going to be discussing a couple of important topics that have gone on recently. Now, I have a little bonus gameplay at the end, and I'm not sure if I'll get to it, and I'm not sure if I'll be able to talk long enough for that. I was just worried that if I didn't put it there, then I wouldn't be able to talk as long, and I'd have too much to say, and, you know, have the last game out of the terrible. And look at that. Did you see that IED that just didn't kill me? Pretty impressive. Now, this is a very impressive gameplay. This is on the first map pack. I think I bought it for, like, no reason. I think I just had a bunch of money in my account, so I was like, okay, just might as well buy it. And this is amazing gameplay. I got in Team Deathmatch. I think it's at least 35, maybe 40 kills. And there's he's back from something. And pretty much around at this point, I'm going ham in this building. Like, this building, if I had ammo in my gun, legendary garage, I told you, if I had ammo in this gun, or if I had infinite ammo in this gun, I would, like, drop the cam 100%. Hopefully you can hear me very well, fairly well. So I definitely would have dropped a cam in this building if I had a bunch of ammo. But, you know, it turns out I don't, and I died. See, I was trying to go to knife that kid. But, I think I'm gonna need the bonus gameplay. Alright, so first thing I wanna talk about is UMG Niagara went down, which is another Call of Duty Championship tournament, but it's LAN tournament, which means local. Ah, dang it, how am I supposed to forget this? I'll remember it later. Local area network, that's what it's called. Oh, here's my brother. But, for that, complexity won, and as always. But the second thing I want to talk about is the new Call of Duty Advanced Warfare, which is going to be taking place in 2058, I think. And a couple things I want to talk about is the mech suit. The mech suit will be in multiplayer. It's confirmed as a kill streak. The big mech suit that is in multiplayer. And I get killed from the back here. Why? I have to carry my team 100%. But that is in multiplayer, and I want to talk about the exoskeleton suits. Now, I want to talk about the multiplayer and single player, and it was confirmed in single player, you'll get the mech suit, the exoskeleton suit pretty close to the beginning, and towards the more progressive that you get upgrades, like a bunch of stuff, you know, jumping and stuff, but where did that guy come from? Two new things that we didn't see in the trailer, which was like, we saw jumping, climbing on walls, everything, you know, from stuff to stuff. But the two things that recently have been announced, I forgot the website, I saw it somewhere. Two things that were announced were levitating. Now, I pray to God that this is not in multiplayer. This means that you can levitate for quite a bit of time, I guess, like 10 seconds. You could levitate to get to a certain point of a head glitch or something easier. Like, I'm beastie. It's terrible. I simply cannot hang. That's it. That's all I have to say. But levitating is one, and that's probably going to be in multiplayer. It's probably going to frustrate the crap out of me. I'm probably going to get really mad. And I'm saying probably a lot. Probably. So the second thing that's been confirmed is speed. I forgot what it's called. It's like where you get like a boost of energy where you can run really fast for a couple seconds. I don't know. It's like Titanfall, if you know what I'm talking about. In Titanfall, the Titans get like this speed thing where they can like jolt to the side. Like if you press A, you like jump to the side or whatever. It's kind of like that. So I'm thinking that there'll be a certain amount of time. I'm gonna need this bonus gameplay. A certain amount of time in between the jumping, so you can't just jump like a shuffle around the map like super fast. But I mean, I don't know. That I hopefully think it's gonna be in it. Like if you're in a hard gunfight and you just, you know, jump or whatever it's called, and it a defensive position, you could get that. I'm very glad that they have that in Titanfall. It's probably Titanfall. And I think that this game is made by Sledgehammer. I think it's going to be fun. But I think the consequence for being a fun game, it's going to be very BS-like. Reason I think it's going to be BS-like is because it's based in the future. And since the future, we know future, right? Future 2025, target finders, most terrible things you can think of. Shock charges. Ugh. Now, this is going to be based in 2058. This is probably going to be target finders with auto-aim, that auto-aims to the target. Like, it's going to be terrible. Like, everything is just going to be bad. But it's going to be fun. And unless Sledgehammer, they've taken 3 years on this, unless that they can make the connection, if they can make it, the connection good, and they can make it fun, I'll be happy. I don't care, because all that stuff is going to get banned. And when my team, quotation marks, is not on, I can play pubs, and it'll be fun. I don't want to just be bored out of my mind, hiccups, the entire time. So another thing I want to talk about is 24. That went down yesterday, and I'm very happy the series is coming back. If you don't know what 24 is, you have to watch it immediately. I'll leave a link in the description about it. But guys, that's all I really wanted to talk about, Call of Duty Advanced Warfare and 24. I don't even know. I had some really awesome gameplays today. So thank you so much for watching. Remember to like, favorite, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys later. Bye. Yeah.